The more I see of Margot Robbie's Birds of Prey, the more I understand her producerial vision, because she's, of course, the producer of the film, and very much in charge, from what I've heard behind the scenes. Although, interestingly, even though she is the producer, I think she almost solely has on her creative hat and not her how am I going to make sure this makes a lot of money hat, you know, her business hat. And I wish someone was above Margot Robbie being like, oh, cool choices, but have you thought of this? Because that's what we're going to discuss right now with this latest batch of photos of Jurnee Smollett Bell as Black Canary filming on location. So where I want to start this conversation today is that, as you might recall, David Ayer made quite a few changes to a lot of very well-established characters for Suicide Squad that were, to say the least, jarring. But ultimately, I found the switch from mobster aesthetic to gang aesthetic to reflect the modern criminal world quite clever. Others, though, never came around. Also, I think Suicide Squad was very successful box office-wise. Like, well, we'll talk about that. I think that has something to do with the character lineup as well. Joker always makes money. Always bet on the Joker card. He's a wild card, and that's what makes it so exciting. And it'll be interesting to see if that maybe rubs off on the Harley Quinn character, of course, because she is literally a spin-off of that character. But you also had Jared Leto doing some very interesting, bold, broad, big screen things there. And then, of course, you also had Will Smith, whereas we've discussed Margot Robbie, in an effort to keep herself front and center as the star, hasn't really given herself any other big name. So the entire burden of getting this thing successful and selling tickets falls on her as a producer and as a movie star. I mean, Ewan McGregor's in the movie, but Ewan McGregor actually has not a great track record of selling tickets himself. But anyway, I bring this up, the David Ayer stuff, because even though he is no longer associated with the DCEU, it seems that Margot Robbie, who he brought into the DCEU, continues to follow at least some of his teachings, because she's also making a lot of changes, and apparently hasn't bothered to read comics pre the New 52. And on that note, I kind of blame DC Comics here as well, because they're the ones who fractured their own continuity and gave Hollywood some choices. Be like, nope, this is it! Go, this is Black Canary. I mean, they're the ones who introduced this alternate version of Black Canary from the pages of the New 52, from which this one is clearly ripped. Where Dinah Lance is primarily, I mean, she has this whole background where she worked for Amanda Waller on Team 7, et cetera, et cetera. But I'm sure in the very pretty pastel comics they handed Margot Robbie, Black Canary is a lead singer in a band, as she was first introduced in the new Batgirl comic before getting her own spin-off series. Fabulous art in all of them, by the way. And I mentioned Batgirl, not only because that's where this new Black Canary was introduced, but, and by the way, Batgirl isn't even in this movie, much less leading the team that she started in the comics. Instead, front and center is the Joker's girlfriend, which is just horrible, horrible optics on this movie. A lot of the people who are fans of this movie would totally call out other projects for doing that, so it's gonna be hypocritical if this movie doesn't take some heat for doing that. In the comics, just if you don't know, Barbara Gordon is shot and paralyzed by the Joker. She can no longer be Batgirl, but she wants to continue fighting the good fight, so she becomes Oracle and starts Birds of Prey with Black Canary and Huntress as her field agents. It's a real empowerment, victim empowerment kind of situation. And now the Joker's ex-girlfriend, who things have gone, you know, well, and they've kind of removed, I'll be curious to see if they keep the abusive angle also. I mean, they're getting rid of all, like, the drama that makes this, like, really real and did in the comics for both characters. But it's not great. Anyway, and so in the New 52, a Batgirl in her comic patrols Burnside, a.k.a. Gotham's Brooklyn. And at first, gentrified Batgirl, the adventures of gentrified Batgirl, they were cute and fun, and again, amazing artwork really helped to sell these comics. But unfortunately, as someone who was reading them, eventually her stories just started to feel too small. And I worry that this Birds of Prey film could suffer the same fate. I mean, it doesn't look like they're filming a movie here, right? It looks like they're filming, quite frankly, a television show. And not even necessarily like a top-notch streaming or cable one either. And just take a look at Todd Phillips and Joaquin Phoenix's Joker movie, also filming on location recently, for proof that low budget doesn't have to mean uncinematic. So I really wish they were stepping up their game. Now, as for Jurnee Smollett Bell herself, she looks very pretty here. Although I do feel, especially when it's going to be plastered on the big screen, that nose ring, very prominent nose ring, is going to take some getting used to. And I say that with all respect to the people who, all due respect to people who think nose rings like that are cool. But you have to understand that it's certainly not a mainstream look, and I think that's for a reason. And while she definitely looks very chic here, I mean, I love the fabric and tailoring of the suit. The suede platform boots are very nice. The double bra, though, that gets out of place when she runs, not a fan of that. But look, she's about to unleash her canary cry, it seems. However, she's missing a crucial element to the character, a defining element. And that's not a martial artist standing before us. I mean, nothing about the way Jurnee Smollett Bell carries herself says martial artist. She seems more like the very well-intentioned lead singer of a band who is maybe burdened. I don't know if it's a burden or she just, you know, only has been using it. Because apparently, like in the comic, they never explained how this worked. They were like, oh, her canary cry can also be used in her performance. And you're like, isn't it like eardrum shattering and like creates like a force? How is she going to use that on stage in a entertaining musical manner? But they were like, oh, she can. So I guess she has different octaves and stuff, you know, and some of them are entertaining and some of them are battle ready. But I mean, and so the idea is, should she just use it for her career or should she maybe use her canary cry to right some wrongs? And that could be a cool character and story. And Jurnee Smollett Bell not only looks pretty here, but also very likable. However, that's just not Black Canary. When Black Canary recently debuted, for instance, in Injustice 2, fans were so excited because of her sweet martial arts moves, which Injustice 2, by the way, delivered. And her best Justice League Unlimited episode? Why, that would be Grudge Match, which is about cage fighting, where Black Canary can hold her own against superpowered combatants because she's just that good. Her canary cry has always been something that's a last resort, an ace up her sleeve in her fights. Because, you know, she would just start every fight by blasting people out of the way. So I think it's actually the canary cry is not even supposed to be that effective because you would be like, why wouldn't you just do that? No, it's like it's just a little extra oomph. It's, you know, as I said, an ace up her sleeve during very well choreographed martial arts fights. So again, maybe this version will work, but it's been proven time and time again now that nothing is as effective or as profitable as comics' accurate adaptations. It's something that the MCU is completely built on, a mantra that Kevin Feige has. I mean, he makes changes here and there, but it's very comics accurate. And DC properties have been the best when they were also comics accurate. Not to say you can't make interesting changes. That's some of the stuff I like the most about what DC does with their film adaptations. But as I've pointed out before, at the core, the characters still seem like themselves. And if you take away Black Canary's martial arts skills, I mean, she would never be... I mean, I guess she has worn heels in the comics, but... That's not the outfit someone who has any martial arts abilities would wear. It's just not the character. And it gives this movie an unnecessary hurdle, as well as Jurnee Smollett Bell. Like, why make her deal with a bunch of fans being like, you're not Black Canary, right? I mean, why not have them say, oh my God, you are so Black Canary? Why not give that gift to the actor so that she can build on that from there instead of having to come from a negative, disadvantaged place. It's unfortunate. Now, speaking of Jurnee Smollett Bell, she did post and then delete a close-up shot at an outfit that she's maybe wearing in the film that's made almost entirely out of fishnet. Black Canary's signature fabric. I think that's a cool idea. And if she wore something like this and had martial arts moves, maybe they're going to work them in there somehow. I don't know. But as I said, she doesn't carry herself like someone who has that ability or that confidence. I think that people will be more excited out of the gate. Now, that's not to say people aren't excited, but I think it's a niche yet potent fan base that's arisen for this movie. A little bit like the fan base for Riverdale, right? Like, it can get it trending on Twitter, gets a lot of attention, but it's not like the most watched television show on the air, right? I mean, that's what this movie should be. So those are my developing thoughts on Birds of Prey. Strong yet limited appeal and unnecessary hurdles. That's not to say that it won't make money. I could maybe at this point, because of the Harley Quinn character, maybe see it getting, if it's a good movie, by the way, getting to the $600 million range, you know, which is pretty darn good, especially if it is indeed as low budget as everyone is saying and it looks. Although I think a really strong comics accurate Birds of Prey movie or a Gotham City Sirens film, which everyone on the face of the earth feels they should have made instead, I think that could have done Wonder Woman numbers. Now, again, Suicide Squad ended up being in the 700s, but I think that, again, has to do with the Joker in there, Jared Leto's choices, and, of course, the star power of Will Smith. So share your own developing thoughts about Birds of Prey down below. And, of course, as always, you can check out some more episodes right now.